Boy, yeah. Luke.
Yeah, good. Nice.
Amen, amen. Let's give God the praise one more time.
Yes, sir.
He's been good to us.
Yes, sir.
Hello, you are our radio listeners. This is William Smith, Grandis from King Solomon Missionary Baptist Church. And this is Talk at Night, Jesus Movement in My Soul radio broadcast. I'm here with Toy Lewis.
Thank you, man.
I appreciate that.
Yeah, I appreciate being here with you. You hear me?
Amen.
Do your thing, man.
Yeah, I will.
Yeah.
Ain't no doubt about that. I'm going to read the scripture and prayer first. And after that, and I'm going to do the announcements about the Dr. Martin Luther King assassination. And I'm going to tell you all the details in just a moment.
Yes, sir.
Right now, let's go to Psalms 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God, that he that made us and not we ourselves. We are people of the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endured to all generations. May the Lord have a blessing to read and hearing God's word. Sanctify our hearts for better understanding. Let's go in the Lord in prayer. Gracious and all wise God, we come to you as we humble as we know how. We thank you for this kindness and your mercy, dear Heavenly Father, that we can study more about you, dear Heavenly Father.
Yes, sir.
And I pray for Miss Wanda McIntyre and our Jesus Movement team.
Yes, sir.
And I would thank for him. I always help them a lot to do a lot of work. We had a close giveaway at the King Solomon Baptist Church. And we did what we have to do, to Heavenly Father.
Amen.
Only you can handle the situation. And I pray for this country, to Heavenly Father, and pray for those students that some of them incarcerated.
Yes, sir.
And I know you're going to handle the situation. In Jesus' name, we do pray. Amen. 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 And thank God. Amen.
Play the song.
Let's get back to Tori Lewis.
Good evening, everybody. This is Tori Lewis with Talk at Night. I hope everybody having a blessed day today.
Yes.
It's a good day. It's rained a little bit.
Sure was.
But it's a good day to be alive. Good day for me to be alive. And happy to be here. You know, shout out to Zoe. I don't know where he is tonight. But, hey, we're giving you a shout out, man. Wish he was here tonight. But show got to go on. So, tonight we have a special guest, Lavon Clack, calling in. Lavon Clack is a mentor. He got his own program at the Louisville YMCA called Promise of America. He's been helping kids in West End, teaching them how to record, produce their own music, and giving them a platform. Tonight he's calling in tonight, displaying, you know, what he's trying to do to get people to bring their kids out to his program and to help them get them out of the streets. And when we come back, Lavon gonna be on. We're gonna play, you know, one of the songs from his kids program, and tonight's gonna be a good night. Mm-hmm. What, you wanna bring him in now? Huh?
We'll bring him in after the song.
Yeah, after the song's over, you know, listen to the song, and when he called in, we got him. So thanks for everybody joining tonight. You know, it's a good day. Everybody have a good Friday. Smile, help somebody today. You know, shake somebody's hand and give somebody a hug and show some love. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Good evening. Good evening. Lavon Clack is next. Is our guest today? You bring him in. Lavon, how you doing today?
I'm doing today, man.
Hey, brother, how you doing? It's a pleasure, man, to have you on the show, man. First, I want to thank you, man, for everything you've done for me, brother. Let me record your kids, man, and give me a platform through the YMCA, man. You mean a lot to my career and where I'm at today, man, and give me an opportunity, man. This is a pleasure to have you on the show. My coming up, man, and, you know, I'm a real guy, and I always look out for the people, look out for me, man. And I want to personally thank you nationwide to the world. I'm on nationwide radio to tell you thank you for giving me an opportunity and helping me build a platform, man. And today I want you to, you know, explain to, you know, just let the world know what you're doing with the kids at the Y, you know, who you are and what you're trying to accomplish.
Okay. First, I want to say thank you, too, for the shout-out, and also thank you for coming up to the Y and working with our kids, because, one, they need to learn how to do all the things that we're doing inside of the program, and it's great that you come in and not only work with them, but mentor them and help guide them.
I appreciate that. Okay.
And their due diligence to make sure that their music sounds great enough quality to where they can feel comfort in putting our music out there where they know that it's done right.
So yes, sir.
I appreciate you doing that.
I appreciate that, bro.
No problem. I appreciate you, like I said. We started Prominent Youth of America in 2019 with the goal in mind of doing youth development, pretty much in helping young people grow and develop into whatever they want to be in life. The role that we used in order to do that was music and entertainment. So one of the programs that we started was called the Arts of Music Education and Entertainment. And within inside of that program, our youth learned about audio production, graphic design, video production.
Yes, sir.
Teach them how to get copyright for their music. We teach them about publishing. The kids in our program are saying so. ASCAP. We also make sure that they understand about Nielsen Media, how to track their music, how to monetize all of their creative content. And also put our music on platforms such as YouTube, and we're currently teaching them how to market and then watch the analytics to help them navigate into the marketing. The skills that the young people learn are considered transferable skill sets, from learning audio production and the systems they get to work on, software, such as like Adobe Audition or Pro Tools, or how they be working on Verizon or Fruity Loops. All of these different skill sets transfer into radio and broadcasting.
Yes,
so I just wanted the kids to be a part of a program, not only where they can grow and develop into entrepreneurs in our musical life, but understand that there's possibilities for post-secondary education within inside of multimedia, and also definitely permanent jobs that they can work inside of multimedia. So we try to pretty much provide an all-inclusive wraparound service for the youth in our program to help them grow and develop. We also take the kids on college tours, Western Kentucky University, to visit the media department, and just so they can get more burns on post-secondary educational opportunities in
all right
fields of study.
Yes, sir. I have a question. I never asked you the question, but what made you want to get into, you know, helping the youth? What was it that you seen in the youth that, you know, you felt that, you know, you wanted to help step in and try to give back in a situation where a lot of preachers and a lot of community leaders done tried, you know, protesting and fundraising and, you know, events to bring awareness to the violence and the drugs and the homelessness and the education? What made you personally want to help, you know, give back to the community?
Well, first off, like, I grew up in the church, and my parents had us involved in youth choirs.
Yes, sir.
Involved in MGMC, Metropolitan Gospel Music Connection Youth Division, which was led by Ms. Jocelyn Claiborne. So growing up, we did Stop the Violence, Start the Harmony workshops. At that time, they invited in people like Ricky Dillard, people like Hezekiah Walker, Orlando Draper, Donald Lawrence, and all these people came in as musical clinicians. So, being a young person and being involved in that, I think that my parents had me involved in. I always had a strong spot for the young people just because of how they have felt like the older generation took it upon us to treat us a certain kind of way. I never wanted to be somebody who couldn't understand their youth because I was so caught up in my career or my lifestyle, whatever, where I couldn't pay them no attention. So I always been tied in with the youth. And like I said, being able to provide them opportunities come from me being provided opportunities, people pouring into me all of my life. So that's one thing I always wanted to do was reach back and give back. So I have certain gifts and talents that are obviously inside of music, but I didn't want the young people in the music to go through the same thing a lot of artists go through, which is that long learning curve, you know what I'm saying, as far as learning, one, how to record a deal artist, and the next step of it is the business of it and how to make sure that you as an artist can remain sustainable. So what I did was I cultivated this program because I'm like, they could be 25, 26 years old by the time they make it out of this learning curve, and I have no work history or anything. So I feel like if I take the time to create a program and a curriculum and teach it to the young people while they're still in middle school and high school, when they get out of middle school and high school, not only will they have a body of work or bodies of work, they'll fully understand how to protect their intellectual property. They'll fully understand how to monetize their creative work and also how to pretty much build up their fans and increase their fan engagement. So this is how we approach this. This is why I approach this. It's all that youth development and pouring into young people the same way people took the time to pour into me.
Yes, sir. I know me and you will be at, we'll be at the wide, and we done seen a lot of different grades of kids come in and deal with them and mentor. And what is one of your biggest things that you believe is wrong with the youth today and what need to be corrected? I may help someone who's listening, a parent that's listening, a grandparent that's listening, somebody, a teacher that's listening, that you may say that you feel that's wrong with the youth that may need to change we as adults may need to do different. Just what advice would you give to just say, hey, this is what I think is wrong is what's going on with the kids in our community.
Okay. Well, I'll say this too. That kind of starts with public policies and procedures. And I'll go into that and say why I'm saying that. Yes, parents are supposed to engage their kids and keep them off the streets, but the streets are the streets, and they are very alluring to our young people. There are certain type of circumstances or systems in place that cultivate that what we have seen. In 2014, they enacted SB 200 here in Kentucky to help decriminalize the JCYD and the DOJJ, which is the Division of Juvenile Justice or whatever. So they start putting the kids in diversion programs. The diversion programs is set up like, say, for example, if I throw the cop, I'll go to court, go to the judge, they'll put me in a diversion program. Whereas originally, if I throw the cop, I may go to JCYD, have to sit down for a while.
Yes, sir.
Then instead of the kids committing crimes in the city and then going right back to the neighborhood within less than 24 hours or 48 hours of them committing these acts. So that sends a bad message amongst the other youth who's watching it. Then you also have to think about young people who are within that of, like who have pretty much emotional behavior disorders, basically.
Yes,
those kids inside of the school system, like whenever they commit any kind of atrocities in the public, it's based on if they took their medicine or not. So if they didn't take their medicine, they'll be declared mentally incompetent in court when it came to the offenses they make. You have all of these different things coupled together, along with elements of, not say this, even though I don't want to, like hip-hop and drill music. So that culture right there where within that of the writing of the materials that these young people are drafting up, they're putting inside of their real-life events that are taking place using real people's names and life situations where people have come to a demand.
That's right.
All of those kind of antics and sarcasm puts inside of the music. We have a plethora of young artists in our city that kind of like participate in the drill music too. And you got to think about gangs in the neighborhoods. You got to think about the access to guns and drugs. All of these different things in our environment help cultivate the negative things that we see as far as youth violence, which promotes the need to prevent it or create as many preventive methods as possible. I utilize our program as a resource to help try to minimize the violence that goes on in our neighborhoods or whatever. But at the end of the day, it's a huge problem that needs to be addressed. I see a lot of people building platforms to help address this. And it's going to be a fight. It's going to be a real fight to, you know, get our city back under control. But it's going to also start with the awareness of the general public of every single thing that happens in this type of nuance. And then go fixing them KRSs and SP200s and get those off the book, or re-modifying those to where, you know, the diversion program is way more strict on our young people as opposed to just putting them right back in with society after they commit offenses.
Yes, sir.
They are currently working on opening up JPYC back up. So, you know,
Do you think it's going to be different? Because I know you're a teacher and you've been working with kids, you know, for a while, for a very long time. And I know you're a scholar. Do you think them opening JCYC? Because on this show, we talk about, the jail. We talk about being mistreated in jail. That's what Bishop's mission is, to try to, you know, help people in jail. That's, you know, being wrongfully done, and people who's being wrongfully done on the streets and being convicted. So what you think as don't open JCYC again, do you think it's going to help, or do you think it's going to continue to be a problem?
I think it can help. I also think that when they do open it back up, they need to invite a lot of youth organizations to the table right at that moment and figure out a system or a scheduling to allow these youth organizations to come inside of JCYC and work with those kids. So make it more customizable for them to figure out what their interests are and what they want to do and get them involved in more youth organizations. When we was growing up, we had a plethora of youth organizations that we could go into. In the time when I was a teenager, it was real hot in Louisville. So it was like a lot of murders. We considered at one point like the murder capital of the world.
Yeah.
The population of Louisville, and growing up during that gang culture and the rise of all of that, like I said, we had a plethora of youth programs which kept things down to a minimum. You had Whitney M. Scholars, you had the Build program, you had Black Achievers, and many other programs where youth are going there every once a week or once every 2 weeks, and then putting them around other kids that's like-minded, that's trying to perpetuate their careers, like go to college and inside of different career fields, inside of Black Achievers, they had engineering plus, communications plus, business plus. Come to these type of places and you see hundreds of kids all dedicated to the program and also looking forward to better in their future. It's very motivating as a young person to see other young people all involved in something that's positive. It's like it's very attractive to young people to see a bunch of negative stuff that's going on when they're influenced and enticed by that and being that culture. So we have to, one, raise awareness about all of the youth organizations here, give all the youth organizations in Louisville, Kentucky the opportunity to work with kids, either whether it be coming to the churches, coming to the community center, going into the justice department and working with the kids that are part of the division program, the diversion program, or going into JCYC when they reestablish it and having it where they can go in there and do classes with the kids. And when they get out of JCYC, have the program out externally too, so they can go and be in the program outside of it just to keep them all off the street. So there's a lot of things that can be done. Is it going to dissipate it where it never is happening? No, it's not. It's not going to disappear. Produce way more positive young people than we are producing right now.
I appreciate that.
Targeted plan of.
I appreciate that. And we're going to take a break. We're going to play one of your songs from your, from the program. I engineered and produced this song. He did a video. We're very proud of this young lady, and we just gonna play a clipping of her song. She, how old is, I think she's 10 or 12 or something like that, Friends?
No, she's a freshman at PRP.
A freshman at PRP. What's her name? What's her full name again?
Her name is Nichelle, and the name of her song is Friend.
Nichelle Friend. We're going to play a little clipping from her song from the local YMCA Teen Tech Center. Song, man, thank you so much, man. I love that song, man. We got another. We hope we can pull the other songs up before we leave. But Lavon, man, I truly appreciate you, man. I truly appreciate you from the heart, man. You've been a true friend to me, man. It's a pleasure to have you on the radio on the Bishop Show, man. Thank you, Bishop, for allowing me to have a good friend of mine tonight to help me get where I'm at today, man. And I just want to give back and tell you one more time, thank you, brother. Thank you for taking me out to Ruckus Party, out to the party with the superstars, man. And hey, we friends forever, man. You hear me?
Yes, sir. I appreciate you too, my brother.
Much love, man.
Much love to you too.
Thanks.
All right, y'all have a good night, man.
Okay.
Right, you too.
I love the light.
In the simple love, in the light of the land, may you all be a bride. In the land, my prayer is.
Yeah, we're having a little buddy. Here's your little
lad. Call me Jam right there. Oh, yeah.
Little lad.
Hey, Billy,
our guest, and we got Bishop Dennis B. Lyons, and I'm here on behalf of Frank O's Family Restaurant, located at 3300 Dick Street Highway. Frank O's is open from 11 to 7 every day of the week. They provide you with good family home cooking.
I want to salute Bishop Dennis B. Lyons for his ministry on the radio and throughout the
community. Mr. Logan, what's up, Mr. Logan?
The people in all walks of life. The
bishop's doing all right.
In so many ways. At Rogers offered in Lyons Funeral Home, we are following his example.
Zo, where you at, boy?
945.
Welcome back. It was a great interview with Lavon, man. I really appreciate him calling in. We're going with Will with the announcer today. Will, man, today is your show, man. Show out, brother.
I sure will. Thank you, Toy. Hello, you radio listeners. This is William Smith, greatest from King Solomon Missionary Baptist Church. Our open leadership with Reverend Charles Elliott is the pastor. Mark this on your calendar. At 12 noon, we're gonna have a National Day of Prayer in Louisville on 6th and Jefferson, 527 West Jefferson Street in Louisville, Kentucky. We ask everybody to come out and enjoy. And one more thing, on Saturday, June the 17th, right after prayer breakfast, Reverend Charles Elliott is inviting you all the men to have a Father's Day peace walk. It's going to be starts at 11 a.m. Walking through from King Solomon Baptist Church to 28th and Broadway.
There's a little song within our breast, with words of hope and love.
Yeah.
The melody blends as we join hands with faith in God above. Dr. Martin Luther King now tells us.
There's a little song that we sing in our movement down in the South. I don't know if you've heard it, but it has become the theme song. We shall overcome. We shall overcome. Deep in my heart, I do believe we shall overcome.
Uh-huh.
Lord, I join hands often with students and others behind jail bars singing, we shall overcome. Sometimes we've had tears in our eyes when we joined together to sing it, but we still decided to sing it, we shall overcome. Lord, before this victory's won, some will have to get thrown in jail some more, but we shall overcome. Don't worry about us. Before the victory's won, some of us will lose jobs, but we shall overcome.
Yes, sir.
Before the victory's won, even some will have to face physical death into the dark chambers of pessimism. And we will be able to rise from the fatigue of despair to the buoyancy of hope. And this will be a great America. We will be the participants in making it so. And so as I leave you this evening, I say, walk together, children. Don't you get weary. Have a great chat meeting.
Yeah, we got a caller on the caller one. We got a caller on caller one. Bring him in.
Good evening. How are you?
Hey, how you doing today, Zoe, man? How you feeling, man? You doing all right?
I miss y'all, man. Yeah.
Well, you back home?
I'm resting up. I'm getting a sponsorship, you know, for my war on discrimination.
Yes, sir. You got to take care of you first.
That I'm trying to do. It's for everybody. But.
Yes, sir. You get some rest last night?
Not too much. I had the plan for today.
Yes, sir. How was the bishop table today?
Oh, man. Bishop table today was actually nice.
Yes, sir.
It was very informative.
Yes, sir.
A young man came and spoke.
Mm-hmm.
He touched on some things that he was taking notes at a different meeting.
Yes, sir.
The bishop's table today, so it was really good today.
Yeah, what was the message?
The message was that a lot of the stuff that we talk about on a daily basis,
mm-hmm.
When they went to the jail,
right.
Stuff that were happening, you know, the police brutality and things like that, they're trying to, you know, like get us to stop, and we request some answers.
Yes, sir.
The chief actually got up and gave some answers.
Oh, that's pretty cool.
And the stuff he, some stuff he answered that I don't even think people were ready for him to be able to stand there and answer.
Yeah, oh, man.
Yeah, anyway. And I was like, man, that was good right there. So nobody left angry or nothing. It felt like people actually got a couple answers that they needed.
Yes, sir. Yeah, my friend was talking about to open up the JCYC back downtown. I was going to come say something about Bishop, seeing if he could take a visit of the new JCYC jail of the youth that they incarcerated. And maybe we can make sure that they being treated right there, because where they at now, they been having a lot of riots and kids been getting hurt and staff has been getting hurt. So maybe when they open up the JCYC, that the Voice of Louisville can intervene there too and make sure that our youth is being protected and treated right also.
Yeah, I think what we need to do is go there and like be looking around, but as we're looking around, we need to have a set of questions that we already come up with before we get there.
Yes, sir.
So we can lightweight be interviewing the staff that's gonna be there.
Yes, sir. What type of staff? You're right.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah, so we can see their mentality.
Yes, sir.
We have to gear these questions in a way so that they will have their response will show us what kind of character that they have.
Yeah, if they got the right people in there.
Yeah, the problem is with these cops and with these CO staff is that they have some different mentality. Like just because they get a job, they get to, you know, abuse people.
Right.
Abuse the authority that they're given.
Right. One thing I know about a CO that I learned from being in prison and jail, they locked up too. Cause all they do is go home and come back and sit in there, and they ain't really got no life. They institutionalized more than inmates. They eat the food and they sit in there and they go through misery. They go through the same pressed out misery that we lightweight go through, hearing them keys and the door shut all the time. Some of them need psychological help they self.
Well, listen, after being there so long, it does do something to you, because the lifespan of a CO when they leave a prison is 5 years.
Yeah. I ain't know what.
So, I've researched like a whole bunch of stuff concerning their mentality and stuff that goes on, because they're locked up longer than a lot of the guys that's going to be there.
Yes, sir.
You got 10 years.
Yeah.
The CO still got to work. No, 20 years before he retires and things like that, And then once they retire, well, once they get, to the 20 years, they still don't want to retire because that's all they know. Here's another thing about CEOs. When they're there, they have to report their friends' names and stuff like that.
Yeah.
They got to report who they know and stuff like that all the time. So if they meet you, you meet somebody that's CEO.
Yeah.
You got to, you know, think that he's potentially... he's potentially keeping your name.
So we got to keep things moving along. We got
to get later on to give it to his staff.
Yes, sir.
So that he can, so that they can look you up to see, you know, what you're about and what, you know, because they're going to determine by your record whether you're a good guy or a bad guy.
Yeah. So we had to go to the weather right now. Zoe, man, we love you, brother. And keep in touch. We'll see you Monday. All right. Stay up, man. And hope you're feeling better. I hope you get everything done, man. We're going to the weather. See, it's going to be hot tomorrow. A cold rain.
Yeah.
Your Wave 3 new storm tracking team forecast.
Okay. Is it this song? Oh.
Jump.
Every time I try to do right.
All right.
Every time I try to treat my neighbor right. Every time I try to help someone along the way. Say them guess
Right now in my way I tell move, move, say,
say,
I want you to move,
move,
say,
say,
I want you to get that out of my way.
That's good.
Show tonight. I appreciate all the listeners today. We got Will. What you got? What's the word for the day, Will?
The word for the day is, all you got to do is trust in the Lord with all thy heart and lean down to our own understanding. Always and not to him. He shall direct your path. Now, remember this. Go with God. He'll go with you. No matter what the test, always try to do your best. Remember, keep that Jesus movement in your soul.
Yeah, thanks. I appreciate it, man. Pretty good to work with you tonight, man.
Thank you tonight, man.
I really appreciate that.
Anytime.
You know, I have a word in that today, too. If you give, you should receive.
Mm-hmm.
If you give, you should receive also. Don't keep giving and blessing people who ain't blessing you back. You know, it's just not right to continue to be used by your lover, your daughter, your son, your granny, and nobody is showing you no love. So, If you give, my friend Michi told me this last night, if you give, you should receive, and he's correct. So if you're giving and you're helping, and don't look for nothing in return, but just know that you can't just keep helping people, man, that ain't helping you. And you can't keep blessing people who ain't blessing you. You know, God blessed people, and they blessed him back. So get rid of the people who's, when I grew up, they called them freeloaders.
That's right.
Yeah, you don't hear that word a lot no more, but freeloaders is real big these days. So watch out for the freeloaders.
Amen. Go with God.
Thank you, Bishop. Big shout out to Bishop Lyons. You the best, man. We love you, man. I don't know what I'd do without you, Bishop, man. And to his wife, I hope she's feeling better. Nikki and everybody at the church. See y'all Sunday at Sunday school. Miss Quisenberry and... have a blessed night.
Peace out. All right. All right. That's it. Man, we did our thing, didn't we?
Yeah.
Oh, man, we did our thing, didn't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. We did our thing, yeah. One for any potato. Then delicious later.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.